Camera, sound, action!
These sounds conjure up scenes that have kept us hooked to the screen as it keeps us on tenter hooks. Adding to the amplified sound of the action scene is the resounding echo of the thunderous applause and the loud catcalls and whistles of the exuberant audiences in every cinema hall across the country, be it the rundown theatre in the rural India or the modern multiplex in Mumbai. The success of a film is gauged not just by box office returns, but also by the clink of coins thrown at the screen by the frenzied fans. It is the die-hard fans that have made Indian cinema into a true magnum opus among all art forms as it depicts life in its myriad modes and motions. Indian cinema is considered incomplete if it did not have a dose of music, a dab of drama and a dash of action, giving it the sobriquet Masala Flicks. The audiences not only swing to the song and dance, they also swear by the sound and fury of fiery dialogues which have become as memorable as the melodies. Every movie buff prides himself in rattling off many a memorable line such as this.
Kitne aadmi the?
Every movie packs a punch with some action, adding a little thrill or suspense to the story. Translating a storyboard into a full-length film can be an exhausting exercise for any filmmaker, but creating even one action scene drains them of their sweat and blood literally. Tinu Verma, noted action director, actor, film director and producer, explains.
Action is a very difficult to execute. The most difficult thing to execute is the action sequence. In action, in moving sequence, moving like train, car chase, horse chase, this is all. I'm director also. My point of view is the most simple execution in the filmmaking. I can shoot like this. But when you came to the action, it should take time. See, whenever I do film with Mr. Rajkumar Santoshi, Mr. JP Datta, Yashji and all, whenever they give me the narration, and the writer never write the action sequence. So that filling the blank, I always discuss with my director. I make 3, 5, 6 sequences, and when they are happy, then I shoot. So you must be know about the knowledge about the camera, editing, and above all, your vision. You should be very clear out your vision, what you want to shoot, what lenses you want to use, what editing point of view you want to cut the shot. The full vision, you are clear about your thing, so easily you can become an action director.
Daring stunt artist Sanobar Pardiwala, who acts as a body double for most leading female stars today, elaborates.
A lot of scene is required and a lot of planning and a lot of effort and a lot of dedication is required towards executing an action sequence and an action scene. It just looks like it's 30 seconds on screen, but to execute those 30 seconds, it almost takes like sometimes 3 to 10 days to execute it.
Action as a genre was a late entry in Indian films. The categories that preceded action were the historical, mythological, and social movies. Action was a part of these films, but never became the main thrust of the film. Hence, the actors of yore were never known as action heroes, but labeled as romantic or tragic heroes. The early actors like K.L. Saigal and Dilip Kumar were crowned the tragedy kings. And even the macho men of the 70s like Dharmender, Jitender and Rajesh Khanna shined as the romantic stars. It was the rising angst of the nation in the mid-70s that popularized the image of an angry young man in Hindi cinema, catapulting to unprecedented fame the fortunes of a rising star, Amitabh Bachchan, with a cult film Zanjeer. His towering personality and booming voice turned him into a true Shehenshah of the industry.
जाओ पहले उस आदमी का साइन लेकर आओ जिसने मेरे बाप से साइन लिया था। पहले उस आदमी का साइन लेकर आओ जिसने मेरी माँ को गाली देके नौकरी से निकाल दिया था। जाओ पहले उस आदमी का साइन लेकर आओ जिसने मेरे हाथ पे ये लिख दिया था। उसके बाद मेरे भाई तुम जिस कागज पे कहोगे मैं उस पर साइन कर दूंगा।
When Amitabh's superstardom started eclipsing, another star rose on the horizon, Sunny Deol, known for his drawl and brawn.
चड्ढा समझाओ इसे ऐसे खिलौने बाजार में बहुत बिकते हैं मगर इसे खेलने के लिए जो जिगर चाहिए ना वो दुनिया के किसी बाजार में नहीं बिकता मर्द से लेकर पैदा होता है और जब ये 2.5 किलो का हाथ किसी पर पड़ता है ना तो आदमी उठता नहीं उठ जाता है
रियल एक्शन हीरो इज सनी देओल When he cut the neck, everybody run. When he shout, everybody run. That aura is there of Sunny Deol. To make that aura, we took 10 years from Ghayal to that Gadar to make him the action hero.
Action started gaining strength at the turn of the century after a surfeit of romantic and family dramas in the 80s and the 90s. Today, the distributors are romancing the action films as they have become the safest bet with 6 out of 10 blockbusters grossing over 100 crores last year. This has redefined the stories as well as the stars. The heroes look more real than real by performing the stunts themselves. Breaking box office revenues with his bravado is Akshay Kumar. He became a front runner for most producers without the backing of any godfather.
आकाश से हम आए तन मन के हम है सच्चे मरती है हम पे लड़कियां बूढ़े और बच्चे पर ना हम अमिता ना दिलीप कुमार ना किसी हीरो के बच्चे हम है सीधे साधे अक्षय अक्षय हम है सीधे साधे अक्षय
Popular actor Kabir Bedi, the first Indian to act in a Bond film, fits the bill as a perfect action hero and can still give a raise to the new faces. But in his characteristic grace is eloquent about our other heroes.
I will say some of our own guys are great action heroes and I think there's no question in a person like Akshay Kumar, for instance, trained as best as any of the stunt guys. And there are others. I mean, there's Ajay Devgan as well. I mean, there's lots of people that can do it if pushed to it. But what is true is that we've not had an Indian that, like a Jackie Chan, has gone and become a major star in America. This is a very strange phenomenon. The only foreign actors that ever get accepted in Hollywood are those who've had some huge success in their own country, which then becomes a success in America. So if we are to get an action hero into Hollywood, the only way is to make an action film, which is Indian, that makes waves in America, and then he will be absorbed into mainstream Hollywood films. If somebody does that, then I don't see why we can't have India's first worldwide action superstar.
Well-known fitness guru Mickey Mehta is well placed to talk about the heroes who dare and bear.
According to me, a few of the heroes who fit the bill of perfect action heroes, I think I will start the list with Akshay Kumar because he truly is extremely agile and he's had a background of martial arts and he truly is so super fit. And of course, like Hrithik Roshan, like Amir Khan, Salman Khan, John Abraham, most of our stars today do a lot of action workshops and they are very well trained. So obviously, most of them qualify being called true action heroes. But I think Akshay probably takes the cake because he is top notch.
The action heroes of the early period were a different cut from the current times. They were not baddies, but seen as do-gooders. Though they may have lacked an agile or chiseled body, the action hero was no less a Superman figure. Beating their build and age, the Bollywood heroes of any age can beat the blues of a villain and handle more than a handful of thugs, deserving all those hugs. He shows his prowess by delivering those jaw-breaking punches, wielding sticks and knives, besides guns, with untold precision, chasing trains and cars to catch the culprits, reining in the bulls and horses to save a damsel and hanging from helicopter to prove his steely resolve and stamina. All of this requires precision and perfection in execution. Every small aspect is given great consideration and every shot undertaken after elaborate planning and checks. Who better than Tinu Varma to explain the possibility of a close shave while shooting as he was a witness to the most horrific incident involving the greatest legend Amitabh Bachchan on the sets of Coolie.
Without vision, planning, nobody directs any film. Action director, bishum bishum, it's not hanging and falling and flying. That is not action director. Technically, should be strong. A, B, C, D, everything should be there. Once you think you want to go through this glass, dil, dimag, and sharir, body, mind, and the heart should be one go, in one sur. Whatever you're performing positively, with full power, full energy, and full focus, then only I go on the floor. I will tell you one shot in Ek Lavya, the Royal Guard. Mr. Jackie Shroff saw his son's dead body. He's lying down on the chhatri and train is coming from 3 kilometers. I'm talking about the ghost train. And Amitabh Bachchan, everybody is standing on their feet. I told nobody can talk. Now I'm coordinating everything. And Manavala, start camera. And train guy also start horning. And crane going up, and we show Jaggu standing here with a shawl, and Jaggu is taking movement to go toward the sun, and camera pan and train come. That is a timing, and the Jaggu shawl went in the engine. Can you believe this? So that is a timing, that is a coordination.
Sanobar says that knowing various skills helps.
It's not only martial arts, but you need to know a variety of things, let's say from swimming to underwater swimming, to horse riding, to bungee jumping, towards skydiving, and a lot of other things. You have to be physiologically really, really good. Really good in the sense you have to have your reflexes so smart that you're able to take the best of the decisions in the split of the second. In fact, in the split of a fraction of a second. So you have to be really good with your physique, your fitness, your diet, and also you have to be psychologically prepared. You have to be a real headstrong person in performing stunts, because that's where your life risk is.
The heroes of the last century were expected to be truly heroic, if not Herculean in build. If the rare films like Dawn or Duplicate exhibited a negative shade by a hero, it was always in a double role of a good and a bad guy, with the latter being bumped off. Hence, even the original angry young man mostly played safe by not displaying the evil side. Sanjay Dutt was the first to make a departure from the hackneyed formula of the hero as a quintessentially good man with his film Khalnayak. Then came an actor who rewrote the roles and his destiny. Shah Rukh Khan dared to don the dark roles in Bazigar, Dar and Anjaam.
Is behte hue lahu ki kasam, is naam ki kasam jo mere dil pe likha hai, tum meri ho, sirf meri. Ye saat phere, ye agni, ye mantra sab dhoka hai. सुनील ने तुमको धोखा दिया है, उसने जो सिंदूर तुम्हारी मांग में डाला है उसी के खून से धुलेगा, ये वादा है मेरा।
With these films becoming big hits and the star turning into a superstar, other actors too were emboldened to depict a negative streak and a weak trait, be it in Gajni, Doom or Wanted. As the characters became more crooked, even the women fell for the look while others feared the guy.
गुंडों से ज़्यादा तो मुझे तुमसे डर लगता है। मैं नहीं जानती कि तुम अच्छे हो कि बुरे।
With the heroes taking on the grey shades and dark roles, they had to look the part too. The current crop were willing for a makeover from bald look to bold get-up, in addition to muscled body build-up. Though Akshay Kumar scores a high in toned look, Hrithik Roshan is seen as the Greek god, chiseled to perfection. While Salman Khan worked on his biceps, John Abraham followed suit to flex his muscles. But it was Shah Rukh Khan and Aamir Khan who popularized the term six-pack. Not to be left behind, the female stars too are ready for the kill, and not just with their killer looks. Though the leading stars, with few exceptions, may walk away with all the credit, the body doubles, however, take the blows.
There are many stunts which are really impossible, and my action directors really keep pushing themselves on me, and that's exactly where I just sit for a couple of minutes in meditation and I visualize the entire stunt performing it to the T. One of my most dangerous stunts is where I was hanging out of the helicopter. I had to rappel down onto a running truck. Both the helicopter and the truck are running at the speed of 80 kilometers an hour. The height was 80 feet and this was in the middle of the desert. And my landing platform was precise 3x3 feet platform. I had to rappel down from the chopper onto the running truck and from there dislock myself, get into the car which is on the truck and get the car down, do a 360 and ride it the opposite way. So it was one of the most challenging and the most difficult stunts.
Despite spotting age-defying bodies and performing death-defying scenes, both the beauties and the baddies are no match for the beasts. The mute animals represent the brute force.
See, to direct the actor and actress is very easy. To direct the animal, to bring working together with the animal, quite risky, quite tough. You must take them very easy, slow and make them to learn. Then you can work with them. Otherwise, animals, once they got the power what they're having, horsepower, nobody's having that.
Professionalism is slowly creeping into Bollywood as it earns the status of an industry. Comparisons with the counterparts in the West are inevitable for the commoner as well as the critic. Most agree that Hollywood action heroes walk the extra mile to pull up their act.
Well, to compare between Hollywood stars and Bollywood stars, I think Hollywood certainly has a lot of research right from pre-production to post-production and while the film is being made, and the way the stars are groomed, or rather they get into the groove, it's just superb and phenomenal. Bollywood is now coming of age in dedicating towards one film at a time and just focusing themselves on one project at a time. Hollywood has been doing this for the last 20, 30 years. And I think Hollywood people are probably a little more disciplined than stars here. But today here, stars are getting extremely conscious and disciplined and very responsible in their behavior. But I think Hollywood is still a little notch above our Indian disciplinary standards. Arnold Schwarzenegger and our Rocky Balboa, Sylvester Stallone and Tom Cruise to name a few. And these people are so, so dedicated to every project. It's like probably what an Amir do for Gajni and Three Idiots and what Hrithik would probably do for Krish. And that kind of dedication. And they will do every possible workshop to fit the bill of the character, especially in terms of looks, especially in terms of capabilities, especially in terms of doing good fight sequences, you know.
O'Hara's treachery has disgraced us.
Drama and melodrama are the hallmark of Indian cinema, in which run-of-the-mill stories with easily identifiable characters of the good, the bad, and the beauty have ruled the roost. After the experiments with art films, there was a rush for the rebellious and renegade heroes. Sholay was a cult film that cultivated a taste for dons and dacoits. With the few exceptions of Yash Chopra, most filmmakers toyed with guns and guerrilla warfare. If the Westerns inspired the Hollywood, the Bhais fascinated the Mumbai's dream merchants. Film shooting had more scenes of shootings than romancing, be it Khiladi or Kante or Kahani. While Hollywood became our benchmark, ironically, we left quite a mark on the West with our eclectic experiments. Maverick director Mahesh Bhatt made bold moves with dark films, but it was Ram Gopal Verma who romanced the underworld with a string of mafia movies like Sarfia, Company, Sarkar, Rakt Charitra, Department.
Hey mama, kallu mama.
Hey, golli mar bheje main.
Bollywood has attained international acceptance and fame, with our films earning accolades and revenue from the overseas market. Though the foreigners are fascinated by our stories, song and dance formula, the action films could not make a desired impact. Even the Indian audiences swear by Hollywood where action films are concerned. Action films involve huge expenses, making it a risky business. The thrilling car chases or crashes and towering infernos or blasts cost a bomb and budgets cannot be overstretched. Tinu Verma breaks no bones about the budget.
Their budget is so big. Karodo arbo ka budget hota hai. International market. Technically, they are far, far superior than us. You just see this film called Avatar. See Titanic, Matrix, where we are standing. No class. Because their budget. Today, simple example, one Sylvester Stallone action sequence is budget of Sholay. So where we are compared the action, we want to do this. Hamara budget ho nahi sakta. When we are trying to do that budget, that film, we can't recover the money.
Sanobar acknowledges that budgets make a difference, but doesn't buy that anyone can better us in terms of dedication and daring.
I think we are much better. It's just that in Bollywood, we are not receiving the right amount of platform towards performing the right amount of stunts. The day we get that right amount of platform and the right amount of professionalism towards performing stunts, I think the stunt artists in Bollywood are really death-defying people, and they are the ones who really put their lives at stake. Do you know why? Because it's just simply their survival. And if a person is working on his or her survival, the person is doing his best. So I think in Bollywood, I would vouch for my Bollywood stunt artists.
Popular Bollywood actor Kabir Bedi, who also made a mark in international cinema, feels we can give a run for the money to Hollywood with a little extra expense and experience.
The last big action film I saw, which was Ek Tha Tiger, I think had some fabulous action scenes. I think Dabang had some great action scenes. I think Wanted had great action scenes. So it's not as though we don't have action scenes. Because we have no hesitation today in importing fight masters and bringing us the same level of knowledge and expertise that Hollywood films have. Although I will say some of our own guys, particularly people like Alan Amin, etc., are terrific. And I feel that where we need to grow a little is the area of really high quality computer graphics. That's where Hollywood is still scoring over us. Now the problem is Hollywood films have Hollywood budgets. And if you're making a film for $100 million, and you spend $5 million on computer graphics, it's bearable. But if you set out to spend $25 million on computer graphics, that's 25 crores. And that becomes a very heavy hit on the film. So maybe that's why some of our computer graphics are not on par or don't have the kind of duration that they have in the West. But that's mainly reasons of cost. But I will say that in the same way that our budgets are rising, we will be able to pay higher and higher amounts for the computer-simulated sophistication of cinema. And I hope to see Indian films that are made for less than Hollywood budgets equal the impact of Hollywood budgets very soon.
Many a times, editing adds a touch of class to action sequences. What cannot make the cut while shooting can be achieved through the right cuts and snips. Technology has given an edge to action films by adding feats and features not otherwise possible to execute. Many big budget films have used special effects and computer graphics to the scenes, taking it to a new level by lending a thrill and class. Technology also has provided the technique to blend and blur the scenes as well as erase the imperfections.
Technology plays a very big role now in the way action sequences are constructed and visualized and executed. Certain kinds of jibs, certain kinds of cranes, you know, which give you height and momentum. So a lot of that is being used. And then as editors, you have to be able to visualize. A lot of times we even shoot buildings like a set of a, say, 20th floor apartment. So I might actually make a set of a house, and then outside the windows, I might put plates of buildings outside, which I might shoot off the 20th floor of a building in Marine Drive. When you have films which are VFX heavy, like say, My Name is Khan, then when you shoot, what happens, say you have to shoot a person, you know, and you want to show that he's against the snow mountains of Himalaya or whatever, you may shoot that against a green screen. And then you send those visuals to a visual effects studio where the green screen is cleaned out and the kind of the plate, the backdrop is inserted, makes it look like the person's right there. So a lot of scope that visual effects give us. You know, a man jumps off a cliff, he's actually stringed to a harness, you know, and then eventually in post-production with visual effects, you clean out those ropes that he was hanging on and you get the feeling that this man just leapt off the cliff or the building or whatever it is. So that way, editor does need to be skillful enough to be able to anticipate and visualize what, when the entire shot gets designed and decorated, how much is it going to add to the experience. And today action directors are really exceedingly good, so their breakdowns, their shot taking, their shot divisions are so accurate.
The machine opened a world of opportunities but also closed some possibilities for man. Shortcuts gave way to easy way out, resulting in authenticity being compromised.
Now what action is going on in the film industry, Indian Bollywood, zero. There is no power, only technique. My point of view, the circus is going on, cable work is going on, authenticity is not going on. What chase I shot in Dar and Linking Road when Shah Rukh fires Sunny. See, energy, power, cutting, taking, authentic locations. I set up the 7 camera in Linking Road with Manmohanji and Yashji. And that day, I took both the hero in the Maruti van. I told Shah Rukh and Sunny, 20 to 35 gap distance, my car is ready there. And I just throw them out of the van. You see that shot? It looked like authentic. And Shah Rukh take turn, my car came, skid, Shah Rukh jumped down and everything well planned, well organized. That is a classy, well planned shot.
Another essential ingredient of an action sequence, be it Hollywood or Bollywood, is the interesting music. Many of the action-packed shots are remembered for the racy background score and raspy dialogues. The music in many a film acts like a clue to the character, whether it is The Godfather, James Bond or Gabbar Singh. Veteran music composer Naresh Sharma gives details of the effects of background scores.
When we come to action sequences, so we used to have this brass orchestra playing, like trumpets, trombones, tuba, horns, like those we used to use 40 violins. Then 4 violas, 4 cellos. So this would create a heavy sound. If you hear the background score of 70s, 80s, you'll hear that sound of the brass and the strings playing behind. If you go to some characters for a film like Sholay, the character of Samba, when the character is to come on the screen, so if you hear the sound behind it, the background score, that composition, that sound, that creativity has enhanced the character so much, then there would be a character of the villain. Whenever the villain appears on the screen, a particular theme appears, theme sound music appears. So these things would make it very interesting. So the reason of lots of films being big hits, the cause would be the background score, equally important as good as songs.
Music lulls us to sleep, stories leave a lasting taste, characters touch our hearts, but action accentuates our adrenaline. Action is more than just acting. It's more than just play acting. It's playing with life and death.